I would say I've been full-time traveling for 16 years. And then before that, there was on and off trips throughout the year. And there's kind of two sides to it. Just turning up to an event and, you know, going on a surf trip, the culture and getting to see a different part of the world and the food and just everything to do with it, like meeting the people and seeing how they live, gives you a really deep respect for where you live and how your life is, and just such an amazing opportunity, and I'd never change it for the world. For me, competitive surfing from a very young age, I knew that that's sort of something that I wanted to achieve. I had so many idols that were, you know, world tour surfers or world champions. So it was pretty clear for me that I was going to work very hard to try and get there. And throughout a solid 10-year period of hard work and dreaming about it, and competing and ups and downs, was amazing, but it's a long road and really hard, and you turn up every event every year and you just putting your mind to it and you're just hoping that it's enough, and it's a crazy roller coaster. Competitive surfing gave me a lot, or gives me a lot, in terms of like how I grow as a person, because I think you really need to understand yourself and how you tick to be able to go turn up to an event and do well. You know, it's your mind that gets in the way of things, and being like settled within yourself, being a good person day to day is a massive thing towards all of just life generally. Whether you're competing or not, like if you can tick those boxes, you're gonna have a good life. It's just a constant journey of learning and evolving. Yes, there's two sides to it, in the sense that it is taxing and you do end up burnt out when you are living out of a bag throughout a whole year. I think any job is taxing when you just do it and do it and do it and you just don't slow down. And when you do slow down, that's the moment where you get to appreciate it and you realize how much you love it. And if you don't in that moment, maybe you're not meant to be doing it. Where I grew up in Australia is a small little town named Byron Bay. It's a really cool, beautiful beaches and quite a unique little part of the world. Having this time at home, and you know, like I really love fishing and I love being out in the bush and nature, and it's just been really cool to kind of do that and slow down a bit. Done a few camp trips down the coast and just surfed for a week and scored some really cool waves that I very rarely get to surf. For me personally, I feel this massive connection to Australia and being in the water with crazy wildlife everywhere. So it's a really special country in terms of how much there is to see, and obviously incredible waves. Growing up and identifying as an Indigenous Australian, having the opportunity to represent with the flag on my shoulder and try and be a really positive role model right throughout Australia, and it's just the beginning of really special, cool opportunities.
up, I left my house just to say you are mine. You might not wanna be with you. Out of city school, right? I'm talking like I knew you before. And I don't even know what to say.
What to say?
You fell in love. You played the game.
You played the game.
I see you though. With your girl games. And you still feel the same. Know what I'm saying?
What I'm saying?
Like, you know what we did. This is not gonna work.
Oh.